Hey everyone, this is Agraj Mishra and I welcome you to the third episode of our podcast, The Intersection Show. If you have seen a previous episode, you would know that we have started a series of business podcasts. Why? So that we can learn the tricks and secrets of the trade from the people who have been there and done that. But if you have not seen that episode, you can check that out in the link given below in the description. Coming back, in this episode, we had an interesting conversation with Mr. Avinash Sethi, who's the co-founder of InfoBeans.
21 years ago,
three childhood friends quit their jobs, came back to Indore to establish InfoBeans. A company which was started with a mere sum of $3,000 now has a market capital of 350 crores. They've moved their business across globe, covering USA, Asia, Middle East and Europe. You can only imagine how inspiring and intriguing their journey would have been, and who better to talk to about it than one of the founders himself. So now, let's get the titles rolling. Good morning, sir, and welcome to the Intersection Show.
Thank you.
First of all, thank you so much for being here. It's a pleasure to have you here.
Same here.
So before we begin, I just wanted to share this with you, that this show is a little different from others. Uske piche ke bahut sare karan hai. Pehla ki ye show thoda sa personal hai. Ye sirf talk show hamari audience ke liye nahi hai. Iske piche ke bahut selfish karan hai. Wo ye ki humne 6 mahine pehle hamara business chalu kiya hai. Aur hum ab usko seekh rahe hain aur samajh rahe hain. तो जब हम रिसर्च कर रहे थे कि हमें क्या करना चाहिए, किस तरीके से बिजनेस को समझना चाहिए, तो हमें एक बहुत कन्वीनियंट सा आइडिया आया कि क्यों ना बात कर ली जाए जो ये सब चीज़ें फेस कर चुके हैं, ये सब चीज़ें देख चुके हैं, एंड दे हैव बीन सक्सेसफुल एट इट. तो व्हाट वी आर डूइंग इज रियली सेल्फिश एंड रियली पर्सनल राइट नाउ.
नाउ आई सी दैट एंड दैट्स द रीजन आई एक्चुअली लाइक द एफर्ट दैट यू आर मेकिंग, बिकॉज यू नो आई सी अ लॉट ऑफ बडिंग एंटरप्रेन्योर्स आउट हियर, यू नो, राइट फ्रॉम द यंगेस्ट बॉय इन द रूम वर्सेस यू, यू नो. And I actually admire what you're doing.
Thank you so much.
So my firm belief is you learn by doing. And if you are able to do it, nothing like it.
And there's also one similarity, which is 21 years ago, you started with your two friends, two childhood friends. And 6 months ago, we four of us started it.
Super.
So you're like 21 years ahead of us and plus 900 people. So that is what we are counting on. And, you know, it's just that through your story, we just want to be inspired enough to be a story ourselves. And, you know, it's just a far-fetched dream to, you know, just becoming an entrepreneur.
You are already an entrepreneur, let me tell you that. And don't worry about numbers. Numbers are just, you know, hindsight bias. So don't worry about that. What I can promise you and assure you is this is going to be a phenomenal journey.
Thank you so much.
You know, if you're enjoying your day, if you're enjoying your work, nothing like it.
So first question.
Yes, go ahead.
That is going to be is, what it takes to make an entrepreneur?
You don't really have to manufacture an entrepreneur. It's just one step out, you know, so which you have already taken, the team has already taken that. You have to take that step out of your comfort zone. And you become an entrepreneur, you know. I'm giving you examples on all kinds of things. I mean, a tea vendor is an entrepreneur, right? And then you know Modi ji is a chai wala, right? So an entrepreneur is somebody who is sensing that there is an opportunity, there is a problem that needs a solution. He or she just comes out and does that. I think in my mind, that is the biggest thing to do. Because it puts you into challenging situations. And if you put yourself into challenging situations, you would be surprised to see the outcome, because you would have never imagined that you are capable of so much. So if I were to rewind and talk about entrepreneurship at InfoBeans level, I graduated from JSITS in 96, worked with TCS in Mumbai, went to US, joined Intel, and by end of 99, I left Intel. One thing that was bothering me was I'm not enjoying my work. I didn't find it enough challenging enough. If it was an 8-hour day, I would be able to do my job in 4 hours. And I have the entire half of my day or more left available to me. So early 99, we did Aapka Indore while we were in our own jobs. It was an e-commerce portal for Indore, and we slogged our asses out, worked late nights, worked on the weekends. And while we were in our own jobs, when I say we, Mitesh, Siddharth and myself, we were in our respective jobs in three different corners of the country. And while we were in our jobs, we had a lot of time available to us. We learned new technologies. Web technology was very new at that point in time. And we didn't even know graphics. So we learned graphics also. So, and just created a portal, e-commerce portal. It had a payment gateway. We were accepting credit cards. We had a back office here. So, and we had like a lot of vendors signed up on the platform. So again, vendors were not capable of doing that. So we used to go and click pictures and upload it on the website, edit those pictures, make it presentable. So this was something that we did right as a pastime, as a hobby, as an interest. But by end of 99, I realized ki, is not much that I'm doing in my current job. I'm not doing justice to what I'm here. And that's when I decided to come back. Now, for an outside world, it looked like a very stupid thing. And, when we three founded the company, we chose to just, accumulate $3,000 and put it in a bank account and start the business. We were very determined that we will not take any help from our parents. We were very determined that we will, try it out. Again, it was a calculated risk. We said, okay, we'll try it out once. Had my valid visa. I was also, there was another technology that came up, which was Java. So I got myself certified before coming from the US. So before taking the risk, I prepared the ground that if I have to come back, I'll be getting a job very easily. So we gave ourselves 1 year with this experiment.
Okay.
And said that, if it works, we'll continue. Otherwise, I'll come back. So that was one calculated risk part of it. The other part was when we set up, we decided our own salary, and usually founders can't draw in more money from the company. So I decided that I'll take 5,000 rupees a month, which is 60,000 rupees. However, I was getting $70,000 in 99 in Intel. I think the currency rate was about 40, 42 rupees. So from $70,000 to 60,000 rupees a year, from Intel to Infobeans, nobody, from a developed economy to a developing country, from Toyota Corolla, which was a car that I used to have at that point in time, to WagonR.
Okay.
And from a, just for the audience and fun, it is from a chance of a foreign girlfriend to a desi girlfriend, right? So that is the risk or chance or stupidity you have to do in order to become an entrepreneur. And believe me, it is fun. So if I go back memory lane, we never realized or we never thought that we'll actually slog and continue to, work for 21 years or have 900 people, or have, we even got listed in the stock exchange, or we'll be, this size. We never imagined. We never thought about it. I mean, it's just like you live a day at a time and enjoy the journey.
But, once you have established your business, apne jis tarike se grow kiya hai, we have realized suddenly ki, leadership is not a one-time thing. आपको लगातार इनिशिएट करना पड़ता है और आपको लगातार एक लीडर बन के उभरते रहना पड़ता है. व्हाट डू यू डू टू ग्रो एंड इवॉल्व एज अ लीडर एवरी डे?
दैट्स अ वेरी गुड पॉइंट. एंड आई डोंट थिंक माई सेल्फ एज अ लीडर बिकॉज आई एम अ बैड प्लानर. आई कांट लीड और आई एम नॉट रियली शोशा काइंड ऑफ ए पर्सन वेयर आई कांट create a vision and then I have everybody aligned to it and this and that. It's not easy. It doesn't come naturally to me. But what I am is, and what I personally feel is works for me is take one thing at a time and work on it in an incremental manner. Okay. whatever I was able to achieve yesterday, I try to be incrementally better today. Mm-hmm. There is a very smart book, a very good book, Atomic Habits. Mm. This guy tells you that, you know, if you can make a very small change, let's say, for example, you know, you have a gym here, just come out and give yourself a task of doing one push-up. How difficult that can be, right? Rather than asking for three rounds of 50 push-ups, or, you know, how difficult it is to come out and do one push-up? I think the science here is that once you are out, then you are ready. Then either whether there's one push-up or 10 push-ups, it doesn't really matter. So going back to the first point is you just have to take that first step. And that is when things starts to roll. But you have to be determined to take that first step. You have to think of how can I better myself in whatever you're doing, whatever. My other goal is try to make it simple. Don't have clutter, don't have complications, just make it simple and try and improve very slightly. But you have to focus on improving. I think one of the important aspects in your own, whether it is your personal life, whether it is professional life, whatever it is, you have to improve. I would like to compare it with, you know, river. A river has to flow. And if river flows, the water stays pure. You can drink from any flowing stream. But if it gets accumulated, it becomes a pond, it becomes a lake, it is going to stale. It's going to, you know, deteriorate. So you have to keep on moving, and you have to keep on just picking up one small thing, one improvement. That's it. I think I wouldn't say it is a rocket science, but it works if you just start to better yourself.
But taking that alignment wala point aapke answer mein se, jitne log hote hain organization mein, उतनी wants अलग होती हैं, उतनी needs अलग होती हैं, perspective अलग होते हैं, and everyone wants a different thing altogether.
Correct.
आप कैसे कर पाते हो कि you know you have everyone on the same boat? कैसे आप, how do you align everyone's vision with your vision?
One thing that we all have to understand when we are working with people is that everybody is a different individual. You have to respect that. You have to respect their choices, their preferences, their fears, their motivations. Right? Once that is there, clear in your mind, what happens is you will get so many people coming to you. They get absorbed in the company, they grow, then they leave. Some people find alignment with your vision and then they continue. You have to nurture these people. You have to, you know, invest in these people. And you have to keep a very simple, very measurable goals. You know, and you have to communicate it very often. Use every opportunity to communicate it. So it will gel in into people's you know, habits, actions, and mind. It takes time. You can't rush it. It will take time. Always think about how can I help, how can I grow that individual. You know, there are people who have strengths. There are people who have weaknesses. How can I highlight those strengths? You know, one thing that is very clear in my, you know, all these many years of experience is that forget about weakness. I mean, you can spend some time and improve on it, but it is not as effective as working on your strengths. Everybody has a strength, everybody has a weakness. Just play on your strength. Like, you know, very simple examples of Sachin. If you are a good batsman, don't try to become a bowler as well. Just become a best man.
So that is what you ensure when you create a team.
Correct.
Okay. But, you know, like the question that I asked, right? Ki, you know, when hum kisi bhi tarike ka vision develop kar rahe hote hain, so what I got from your answer was ki it is really important to have everyone aligned in a way ki har kisi ko lage ki ye jo vision hai ye mera hi hai. हर किसी को उससे सेपरेटेड फील ना हो कि उसको ऐसा लगे मैंने नहीं सोचा ये किसी और ने सोचा था. तो एवरीवन इज कम्युनिकेटेड इन दैट मैनर कि एवरीवन फील्स लाइक होम, लाइक अ बिग फैमिली. दैट इज व्हाट वी टॉकिंग अबाउट. बट देन टू हैव विजन यू नीड टू हैव आइडियाज फर्स्ट थिंग. सो एंड एज अ क्रिएटर व्हेन वी हैव आइडियाज वी टेंड टू गेट बायस टूवर्ड्स देम. कि यार ये जो मैंने कहानी लिखी है ना इससे अच्छी कोई नहीं लिख सकता, एंड दिस इज द ओनली वे टू डू इट, एंड दैट इज व्हाट आई यूजुअली आल्सो डू. कि यार मैं जब अपनी कहानी किसी को देता भी हूँ पढ़ने के लिए, तो आई ऑलरेडी हैव दैट इन माय माइंड कि यार ये कुछ भी बोल ले, आई नो व्हाट आई हैव डन. तो ये जो बायसनेस वाली चीज़ होती है फॉर योर थिंग्स दैट यू आर क्रिएटिंग, फॉर द आइडियाज दैट यू हैव हैड, और द थिंग्स दैट यू आर इनिशिएटिंग, हाउ डू वी सेव आवरसेल्फ फ्रॉम दैट बायसनेस?
I would not want to save myself. I would not even call it bias. I will call it as a passion, the obsession. You know, so मैं कई बार बोलता भी हूँ कि ये तो entrepreneurship ऐसा है जैसे प्यार में पढ़ना. पढ़ गए तो फिर उसके अलावा वो चश्मा लग जाता है, तो उसके बाद दुनिया वैसी चश्मे से दिखती है, कुछ भी नहीं दिखता उसके अलावा, right? So वैसे ही concept है कि you can't be thinking about taking, getting away from that. You are into it. You are deep into it. आप उस idea के या उस thought को लेके you are extremely passionate about it. Now the point here is how I take it further. How do I execute it? Now how many people get aligned to it? Not everybody will, right? So you continue to run with it, right? And you will have people. As I said, you have to continually communicate. And you will find people who start to buy in. Now they might not be as aligned as you are, which is normally the case. But then, if you give them perspectives, if you give them what is the benefit for them, if you tell them that how it is going to go, I think they will certainly follow. So in our own company, we have several people, several. We don't call anybody employees, we call them team members. And then there's an upgrade for a team member also. So we have a path where we give them a motivation that if you are a team member, you should aspire to become a partner. A partner has stock options. So even before we went public, we gave stock options to them. So these partners are the ones who are more close to us, who are more involved in day-to-day decision making, who are more involved in, and these are the people who see them as a potential set of people who are going to take the company forward. So that is where you have to start to, you know, build your own close circles where you know that these are the people who are aligned with the idea, who are culturally aligned, and who have the willingness to run longer. So this is how you'll have to, again, pick and choose, as I said. But you have to have respect for everybody, those people who are not aligned with your idea, those people who are aligned, partially aligned, and fully aligned. But you have to trust and, you know, respect everybody. So that's how it is.
The more we generate ideas, the more we are exposed, the more we are, there and out there for rejection. हम जितना ज़्यादा आइडिया जनरेट करेंगे हम उतने ज़्यादा चांसेस भी हो जाते हैं रिजेक्शन के. आइडिया नहीं जनरेट करोगे तो रिजेक्ट होगा ही नहीं.
करेक्ट.
सो व्हाट डू यू डू विद दैट? हाउ डू यू डील विद रिजेक्शन योरसेल्फ?
दैट्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग पॉइंट. सो इफ आई गो बैक टू द सिमिलर थॉट, अर्लियर थॉट दैट आई शेयर्ड, इज यू हैव टू कॉन्स्टेंटली स्ट्राइव टू बिकम अ बेटर वर्जन ऑफ योरसेल्फ. ओके, नाउ इफ यू पुट दैट फ्रेम ऑफ थॉट, देन एनीथिंग दैट यू आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम द आउटसाइड इज स्टिल एन आउटसाइड व्यू. Rejection is an outside view. It is not your view. You are still passionate, right? तो अब कोई लड़की आपको पसंद आ गई है, अब माँ ने मना कर दिया है, पिताजी ने मना कर दिया है, it doesn't matter. What is the rejection here? Correct? कोई idea से आप passionate हो और आपको करना ही है, वो कोई लोग कुछ भी बोलें, it doesn't really matter. हालांकि यहाँ पर थोड़ा सा smart होने की भी ज़रूरत है. When I go back to the calculated risk aspect, we gave 1 year. You have to put all your energies into one idea, whatever you're passionate about. Try and work on it. Honestly. Don't leave any stone unturned. और उसके बाद भी यदि नहीं होता है तो then you have to move on. You can't be passionate forever for a girl who is married to somebody else. Doesn't make sense. तो थोड़ा सा वहाँ पे सेंसिबिलिटी लाने की ज़रूरत है. लेकिन जब आप पैशनेट हो तो फिर दुनिया वनिया सब बंद हो जाती है. फिर यू हैव टू बी देयर. वो ईमानदारी से पूरा काम करना पड़ेगा. ऐसा नहीं कि मैं बेस्ट फिल्म मेकर बनना चाह रहा हूँ या बनना चाहता हूँ, पर मैं इफर्ट नहीं लगा रहा हूँ उसके लिए। सुबह 4 बजे उठ के जाना है, सनराइज़ का कोई सीन लेना है और मैं आलस कर रहा हूँ, तो फिर वो मतलब इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क।
वो आपको खुद को समझ जाना पड़ेगा।
वो तो यू हैव, मैं वही बोल रहा हूँ, यदि आपका व्यू क्या है कि मेरे को अपने आप को बीट करना है, तो वेयर एम आई टुडे? ओके, आई एम एवरेज, कैन आई बी बेटर देन एवरेज? और इफ आई स्पेंड लेट्स से 30 डेज, व्हाट वाज माय परफॉर्मेंस इन ईच ऑफ दोज डेज? एम आई इम्प्रूविंग? डेली लेवल पे भले नहीं कर पाए मेजरमेंट, लेकिन मंथली या क्वार्टरली या ईयरली वो मेजरमेंट तो करना पड़ेगा।
बट देन सब चीज़ करने के बाद भी देर इज ऑल्सो दिस वन थिंग ना, कि आपको फेलियर तो मिलेगा ही इन यू इनिशियल फेजेस। हमने जिस तरीके से डिसाइड किया था कि वी गेव अवरसेल्फ 3 ईयर्स, कि यू सस्टेन योरसेल्फ फॉर 3 ईयर्स, एंड आफ्टर दैट अगर आपकी दुकान 3 साल तक चल जा रही है, लाइक 1000 डेज आप चला पा रहे हो दुकान, तो आपकी चलेगी, राइट? बट देन यू हैव टू सस्टेन, यू हैव टू वर्क हार्ड 24/7 फॉर दीज 3 ईयर्स। हमने इसको इस तरीके से करा था, बट देन द मोर यू एंटर द मार्केट, आपको उस फेलियर कहीं ना कहीं से मिलता है, एंड इट्स एवरी डे प्रोसेस, राइट? यू विन एवरी डे, यू लूज एवरी डे, पर यू कैन नॉट हेल्प इट आफ्टर लर्निंग एवरीथिंग। और आप सब चीज़ पॉजिटिव माइंडसेट के साथ काम करो, बट फेलियर विल लीड टू नेगेटिविटी, वो होगा ही, और वो नेगेटिविटी सीक्स इन सम हाउ, राइट? हाउ डू यू डील विद नेगेटिविटी?
इट्स वेरी नेचुरल, आई थिंक। अगेन मेरा जो पर्सपेक्टिव है कि आप फेल हो गए, कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, आपको रिजेक्शन मिलेगा, क्रिटिक्स होंगे, सब होगा, एंड दैट्स पार्ट ऑफ द प्रोसेस। Take that as an inspiration. Take that as another challenge, and try to deal with that. I think one of the strongest attribute that entrepreneur has to have is usko moti chamdi ka banna padta hai, and usko galiyan bhi sunni padti hain, usko failures to dekhne hi padte hain, usko sab kuch karna padta hai, uske baad bhi wo uth ke khada hona chahiye usko. I think wo to karna padega. Aur ultimately mera ye kehna hai ki what is there to lose? Ultimately, it is all relativity. मैं failure इसलिए देख रहा हूँ कि वो successful दिख रहा है, पर मैं बोल रहा हूँ कि मेरी लड़ाई तो मेरे से ही है ना। If I am trying to become better version of myself, वो कुछ भी हो उससे मुझे क्या फर्क। For example, InfoBeans, in there we have spent 21 years. You know, you might think that we are good, we have actually attained a success. But I have several examples where they are 21-year-old companies, they are 4 times, 5 times bigger than us. There are several examples who are again 21-year-old companies which are probably 10 times lesser than us. Now I have to choose my battles. Mujhe ladi usse karni hai, isse karni hai. इसको देख के खुश हो जाना है कि यार आई एम वेरी हैप्पी, आई एम एट अ वेरी गुड लेवल, या उसको देख के मुझे रातों की नींद उड़ना चाहिए। I would say don't do either of that. Think of what is your goal. आप आज यदि इस लेवल पे हो तो what is it that you want to do further? Are you happy with it? You know, so I think you have to keep a balance. One is you should be definitely happy with whatever you're doing. If you're doing it honestly, you should be happy naturally. But if you're not doing it honestly, then there has to be a dissatisfaction, there has to be discomfort.
But then there is this concept of time, na? Ye to hota hi hai na, ki aap, when you're moving forward and you're doing something.
Time is a misleading concept. Huh? I don't believe in time. And that is again one of the challenges that people see. Ki, you know, I mean, I don't really have any concept of time. Mm-hmm. And I get a lot of flack because of that. Mm-hmm. From my wife, from my partners, from a lot of people. Mm-hmm. But that is what I am. I mean, I feel time is again a very, very misleading concept. I would be as happy as I was 10 years ago. I was as happy as, you know, when I started the company. I was as happy as when I was in job. Mm-hmm. Why? Because my thought was that whatever I'm set out to do, I should be doing that. Mm-hmm. If I'm a student, I should be a student. Mm-hmm. If I'm, you know, taking up a first job, I'm in a training program, I should not be sleeping there. I should be doing something. I mean, some meaningful use of that time. In whatever role you are today, you need to do meaningful duty there. That's it. That's the simplest formula to stay happy. Ultimately, what is success? Success is your own determination. You know, I don't want to call myself successful because 1000 log successful bol rahe hain. Kyunki 10,000 aur bhi hai jo bolenge ki successful nahi ho. What's the point? I have to be successful in my eyes. And what is my desire? Right? I don't want a lot of money. I want better sleep. So these are my parameters of success. कि शांति से सो पा रहे हैं, you know, कुछ उल्टा सीधा काम नहीं कर रहे हैं, ज़्यादा पैसे जल्दी कमाने के लिए. If you are happy in doing that, and if you are happy in your work, यदि मैं रोज ऑफिस जाके शांति से अच्छे से काम कर रहा हूँ, and I know कि this is good stuff that I am trying to do, more than enough. I think ये जो भी external pressures हैं, failure का या success का, ये सब मिसलीडिंग है, वेरी वेरी इनकरेक्ट.
ज़्यादा भाव दे रहे हैं हम इनको, ऐसा
ज़रूरत ही नहीं है ना, ज़रूरत ही नहीं है.
बट जब आप जॉब में थे, जब आप US में थे और जब आप यहाँ पर आ गए, इन तीनों जगहों पे व्हेन यू एंटर सर्टेन फील्ड यू रियलाइज दिस इज़ नॉट अ लाला लैंड. और ऐसी बहुत सारी सिचुएशंस क्रिएट होती हैं जो आपने कभी शायद प्लानिंग में देखी नहीं होगी. लाइक वी टॉक अबाउट 3 P's, लाइक प्लानिंग, प्रिपरेशन एंड पेशेंस. हम इन 3 P's की बात तो कर लेते हैं, बट देन देर आर सर्टन अनफोर्सिन सर्कमस्टांसेज जो आपको समझ नहीं आते हैं, एंड दे पॉप आउट ऑल ऑफ अ सडन. यू थिंक दैट डे वॉज एब्सोल्युटली अमेजिंग और शाम को एक चीज नई चीज आ जाएगी, राइट? हाउ हैव यू डील्ड विद दोज अनफोर्सिन सर्कमस्टांसेज योरसेल्फ?
ओके, सो आई नेवर प्लान एनीथिंग. आई कांट प्लान एनीथिंग. सो आई टिपिकली थिंक ऑफ बिगर ब्लॉक्स, bigger rocks to address, or bigger problems to address. And thankfully, I was able to get people around me who are good at execution. And I trust them very highly. I delegate those things and keep a track of those things. I'm also bad at follow-ups because, you know, I don't get the sense of time. Ki abhi nahi hoga to phir kaise hoga, you know? So my wife is extremely opposite, right? So she will plan everything. If follow-up bhi ek is samay karna hai, to wo hoga. Aur uske baad wo jawab bhi aisa aayega, to iska matlab ye hai ki nahi hoga. You know, all of those things. I can't really get that. So I am bad at this. My partners are very opposite. My partner Mitesh, he can plan years in advance. And all of our family travel or the group travel happens because he books all of those things. I can't do that. I'm incapable of planning. Now, I think I'm told, and I also believe that I'm any unfortunate situation, I would be probably just trying to figure out what is the way out or what are the options I have. Things that I can control, things that I cannot control. So I know that things I cannot control, I'll be at peace with it. And things that I can control, I try and attempt that. So one example I would want to share is I was new in the US and it was 98. I bought a second-hand car. It was Honda Accord. And highway drive was very new. And I used to drive about 30 miles one way for my office. And it was probably first week of the car. It was a used car. And so first week I was going to the office. And all of a sudden, there was smoke coming in from the tire on my side. And I was wondering, ki kya ho raha bhi? You know, how do I slow down? You know, what to do? I was at 80 miles. And, you know, in the US, you can't slow down because otherwise somebody will hit from the back. And then I realized that the smoke, and then there's a fire, and then the tire actually got burst.
Okay.
At a high speed.
Okay.
All I could do was, you know, just put on that emergency light and try and get into the side, get to the curb. And then I don't know what to do. And there was no mobile at that point in time. I was just standing out there. Then I realized there are some poles. There are some poles where there's some numbers written. You can go dial them and then somebody will come and tow you. So that was a very scary moment, but I don't think I was very troubled that particular point in time. I mean, still, it will be very detrimental because somebody can hit you from the back. Mm-hmm. And what to do after that, you know, when you are on the highway, what to do there. Mm-hmm. Right? So, but it just happened. It just passed. So I would, in any situation like that, I'll just try to figure out what are the ways out rather than panicking about it. So probably this is my natural tendency.
Okay.
The other, as I said, my weakness is I can't plan.
Okay. But when you say that you can plan, the most popular theory is that productivity is directly related to planning. Right? How do you enhance your productivity otherwise?
Okay, that's a tough one. So, I don't know whether it is relating or not, but I usually like to sleep and sleep more when I'm in trouble. Again, a very funny phenomena. Family members don't understand that if I'm in trouble, how can I sleep? But that helps me relax my mind. The other thing that I do get inspiration from and get a lot of tricks from the books which I read. So one book I mentioned earlier was Atomic Habits. There's several other books that I feel are very, very useful. And typically we are in a knowledge business. We are in managing people and smart people. So I like books which allow me to understand human psychology and how to handle them. So there's very simple, very basic book most of you must have read. If not, you should. It's How to Win Friends and Influence People. Mm-hmm. This was my first book, which I was gifted by my colleague in TCS. Mm. And that is when I catched this reading bug. Mm-hmm. Now, expanding that, we have started reading clubs in our company, where we have first 6 months defined that these are the first six set of books that one should be reading, and enhancing their understanding of a lot of things like how to handle people, how to communicate, how to do public speaking, how to improve your habits. There's one more on gender. How do you balance gender bias? There's a brilliant author, Taslima Nasreen, mind-blowing. It tells you how many places your bias against the other gender, and knowingly, unknowingly. But then you start to read it, you start to become conscious, and you start to understand that, yes, these are the things that you're not doing correct. So, reading helped me improve my productivity, staying focused.
What I get through this is, I like this idea very much, ki through distribution of books, आप अकाउंटेबिलिटी पार्टनर्स क्रिएट कर रहे हो कि द मोमेंट आपका प्रोडक्टिविटी या आपका फोकस जाए यू हैव समवन एल्स टू टेल यार आज मैंने है ना आई रीड दिस एंड दिस इज सच अ गुड थॉट ये दिस शुड हैव हैपेंड राइट एंड सो मेनी टाइम्स
एंड दिस इज इन माय ओन इंटरेस्ट यू नो सो आई हैव थ्री मेन इंटरेस्ट वन इज रीडिंग वन इज रनिंग एंड थर्ड वन इज फोटोग्राफी सो आई क्रिएटेड अ क्लब फॉर एवरीथिंग ईच वन ऑफ दीज मनन इज रीडिंग क्लब तस्वीर इज फोटोग्राफी क्लब And Sehat is our fitness club. So, जब मुझे आलस आ रहा है तो मैं देखता हूँ यार ग्रुप में इतने लोग कर रहे हैं और मैं नहीं कर रहा हूँ तो देन आई यू नो गेट एम्बरेस्ड तो जो आपने लीडर वाली बात बोली थी कि लीडर को तो ऑन द टोज रहना ही पड़ता है तो ये ट्रिक्स हैं अपने आप को इंजेक्ट करने की कि अरे यू नो जाग जाओ सिमिलरली इफ यू आर लेजी इफ यू नॉट रीडिंग बुक्स देन यू नो कि यार यू नो अगले महीने सेशन में क्या बोलोगे Right? So you are planting things in a way that it comes back to you. And then you are accountable, as you rightly said. Once you are, so I typically, if I'm lazy in a month, and then next month I'll announce in the forum, in the WhatsApp group, that I am going to run 100 kilometers in a month and 150 kilometers cycling in a month. I started running marathons in 2015. And I started because I saw on Facebook, my college mates, my peers, they were all completing 21 kilometers and 42 kilometers. And I said, abhi Indore mein marathon hone wali hai, January, Feb mein. To 10 kilometer hai, 5 kilometer hai, 21 kilometer hai. 5 mein to sharminda ho jayenge. To 10 ka target karte hai. That's what I thought. I tried running. I couldn't run. Aadha kilometer doda honga. And I said, ki baap re, itna hota aadha kilometer. And that day, एक किलोमीटर भी नहीं हुआ होगा रन वॉक करके देन टू डेज ब्रेक थर्ड डे फोर्थ डे स्टार्टेड अगेन एक किलोमीटर हो गया बट लगा कि यार 10 तो मुश्किल है आई डोंट नो हाउ फार वी कैन गो तो बट ठीक है अगले दिन फिर ट्राई किया तो एक हो गया फिर डेढ़ दो ऐसे करते हुए I was able to cross 10 kilometers and there were about 20 days left. So, jo bhi mere mentors hain, coaches hain, unko maine bola ki yaar 10 to kar liya hai, ab kya kare? तो बोले यार अटैम्प्ट 21 तुमने रजिस्टर तो किया नहीं है अभी, तो कर लो। ठीक है ट्राई करते हैं। तो 10 फिर 12 फिर 14 16 वन वीक अहेड ऑफ मैराथन दी अकेडमी इटसेल्फ दे ऑर्गेनाइज्ड 16 किलोमीटर रन एट इन सुपर कॉरिडोर। सो आई डिड 16 बट आई डिडंट स्टॉप। आई सेड कि यार मुझे तो 21 करना ही पड़ेगा। सो एवरीबडी वाज रेस्टिंग, वो खत्म हो गया था उनका, आई विल रन 5 मोर एंड आई डिड 21। तो द पॉइंट आई एम ट्राइंग टू मेक एंड फॉर यू फॉर एवरी ऑफ योर ऑडियंस इज व्हाट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट इज कुछ भी एक आपको काम करना है ना, तो जैसे फिटनेस का काम है तो जूते पहन के घर से बाहर निकल जाओ, दैट्स इट। आई थिंक वो 50-60% बैटल बिस्तर से उठने का, कमरे से बाहर निकल के जूते पहन के बाहर आने का, यही बैटल सबसे बड़ा है। वंस यू आर आउट यू विल डिलीवर योर बेस्ट। आई कुड इमेजिन कि मैं 10 के भी आगे बढ़ पाऊँगा, 10 भी कर पाऊँगा कि नहीं। आई कुड एक्चुअली ब्रीच 21 और अगले साल मैंने 42 भी किया। इट्स ईजी टू डू, यू नो यू कैन डू इट, इट्स स्लाइटली डिफिकल्ट बट डूएबल। इट्स नॉट माउंट एवरेस्ट, इट्स लाइक राला मंडल जाना है। तो जा सकते हैं, मतलब ऐसा थोड़ा ना कि नहीं जा सकते, पर आपको बोलेंगे यार माउंट एवरेस्ट जाना आज ही, तो यू कांट डू दैट। आप उठोगे नहीं, बोले छोड़ो यार बेवकूफ जैसी बात करता है। करेक्ट, आई थिंक दैट इज द ट्रिक, दैट इज द ट्रिक। यू हैव टू चूज योर बैटल्स, यू टू टेक वेरी टाइनी थिंग्स एंड डू दैट। वंस यू डू दैट यू विल डेफिनेटली वॉन्ट टू डू इट बेटर। जैसे मैराथन का भी बताऊँ मैं, जब मैं 5 किलोमीटर दौड़ने लगा तो मुझे 5 में मज़ा आना बंद हो गया। मुझे मज़ा 6 में 7 में 8 में आएगा, अब 5 में मज़ा नहीं आता है। तो यू हैव टू बीट योर सेल्फ, यू हैव टू कम आउट ऑफ कम्फर्ट जोन। इफ यू आर कम्फर्टेबल देन देर इज समथिंग you are missing, you should change that.
Amazing. But then Nick, talking about the productivity killer, that is distraction, right? What I found out is I was distracted to social media apps like crazily. मतलब मैं फोन चालू करके बस स्क्रोल कर देता था, जैसे आप इंस्टाग्राम की फीड स्क्रोल करते हो फॉर नो गुड रीजन एट ऑल। आप कुछ नहीं कर रहे हो, 1, 2, 3 एंड देन यू नो स्विच इट ऑफ अगेन। सो हाउ डू यू डील विद डिस्ट्रैक्शन, मतलब हाउ डू यू सेव योरसेल्फ फ्रॉम दैट?
दैट्स क्रेजी। सो आई एम कॉन्शियस अबाउट इट एंड आई स्टार्ट टू टेक, जैसे व्रत होता है ना आपका कि आप खाना नहीं खाओगे, तो आई टेक सोशल मीडिया व्रत कि आज मैं सोशल मीडिया में नहीं जाऊँगा या एक वीक नहीं जाऊँगा, ऑल ऑफ दोज थिंग्स आई डू दैट। आई हैव डन 10 days ऑफ साइलेंस वेर आई डोंट स्पीक, आई डोंट टॉक, आई डोंट इवन रीड, आई डोंट हैव माई फोन, आई डोंट वर्क, आई जस्ट गो आउट एंड जस्ट स्टे साइलेंट। दैट्स ह्यूज, राइट? सो we all need to be extremely aware of our distractions around us. And again, going back to the same thought of how are you going to be better, how are you going to work on yourself if you are getting distracted with so many things. So social media is a killer, is a time killer, huge time killer. So I put off my notifications. I don't get calls. I stopped taking calls from unknown numbers. I switch off all notifications on my phone. I don't have Facebook on my phone. I try to be on least possible mediums which are like compulsory otherwise. So only WhatsApp is what I have. Business point of view, yes, I do go to LinkedIn, so as a medium. But I try to be very, very restrictive. Second thing is I try to give time to every activity. For example, I manage finance, so this is check signing is an activity. So I said, you know, there is only 1 day or 2 days in a week I'll sign checks. You don't have to come to me every day, every now and then. This is a distraction, right? So I try to have 30-minute slots or 1-hour slots where I have zero distractions and just focus on my work. So work from home typically for last 9-10 months. So it was a difficult time for me because I get distracted very easily. I like to get focused and work. So I started working and going back to office from June itself.
I would like to talk more about that detox practice that you talked about, of staying silent. right? How has that worked for you? Please tell me more about that thing jo 10 din ke liye aap chup rahe. I would like to know more about it.
This is phenomenal. See, one of the problems that each one of us is ego. Okay, so all those failures and rejections and the desire to be the best is all misleading. Is all because of the ego. The moment you stay silent and stay in your house, just stay silent. Let everybody know that you're not going to respond to anything. No gestures, no communication, no messaging, nothing. Right? By the end of the day, you will realize that you become so irrelevant. You are nobody. Because they know that if they talk to you, you're not going to respond. So you're just sitting as a showpiece in the corner. And things are moving beyond, I mean, without you as well. That's a brilliant exercise in controlling or handling your ego and realizing that you are a tiny speck in the universe. Mm-hmm. Nobody. Mm-hmm. So a whole lot of problems get solved.
But then moving from that spiritual side to the capitalistic side, in the business sector, when you start in your initial phases and everything, how would you count yourself successful? Because if you're not earning money, if you're just, you know, focusing on the inner growth, right? How would you coin yourself as successful, and how would people coin you as successful?
See, you are never successful in the eyes of people. Okay? But if you sleep well every night, you're successful. Okay? No amount of money, no amount of material wealth can make you happy. It is only your, you know, self-satisfaction that will make you happy. It is not a problem if money makes you happy. But soon you will realize that after a point, money doesn't make any change. So for example, any amount of wealth that I get today from this point onwards is not going to increase my happiness by any factor, but not even 1%, right? If I go back in time, 10 years ago, again, any amount of wealth that I added up in last 10 years didn't added any iota of happiness in me, which was already there, right? So beyond a point, whatever things that we attach happiness to, we start to realize that it's not that. So it is in the journey, we just keep on changing that goal, and we figure out ki happiness doesn't come from any of these external things.
Mm.
It is my own internal choice.
Mm.
Nobody can reject me or mark me as a failure or successful. Nobody can do that unless I allow that person to do that.
Mm.
So it is only me and it is only myself that will tell whether I am happy. Mm. And the easiest measure is whether I can sleep well in the night or not.
Amazing. And talking about that, your journey, which you talked about, like this 21 years, what do you think is the most important risk of your life and why? The most important risk that you took?
The most important risk, I would say, probably two of them, is one is, which I talked about in the first thing, was leaving everything and starting a business, a venture. I left US, Intel, and everything. But with the idea that, yes, I just want to do this, totally blinded by it, which is where the passion comes in.
Mm-hmm.
You know, similarly, it's more of a personal thing, but I'll still share. I married a girl which I was in love with, and the situation was our parents were not agreeing, her parents were not agreeing, so we had to run away. We had to elope. So I just go back in time and think why we did that, you know, how we did that. The whole point is that we were so obsessed with each other that the rest of the world didn't matter to us, including our parents.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I feel bad about it sometimes, but the point I'm trying to make here is that entrepreneurship is all about that obsession.
Mm-hmm.
It's like obsession with a beloved. Your business is like that, or your idea is like that. You will not regard anything else in the world. Anything, and when I say anything, means anything.
Mm-hmm.
you would not even, you know, in a sane mind, you will not be able to do it. That's the reason why a lot of MBAs, they can't start their business. Because they've got an overdose of sanity. You got to be partially insane. It needs to be, I mean, people are telling that you are stupid, probably you are good.
I get it.
No amount of, I mean, you can't really start with a lot of sanity. It doesn't happen like that. You have to be slightly insane.
This was an amazing answer, sir. And now coming back to the firm and the coming back to everything that we were talking about, once you start your business and once you grow and once you reach at a certain level, what I have felt so far is ki mere dimag mein ek chota sa phenomenon ye hai ki yaar aap kisi na kisi tarike se idhar udhar karke ek jagah bahut zarur jaoge, right? You're gonna reach there, but in that journey, agar aapne us cheez ki taiyari nahi ki, if you're not prepared to be successful, if you're not prepared to be a winner, आप बहुत जल्दी नीचे आते चले जाओगे. तो उसके लिए आपकी एक प्रिपरेशन बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरी होती है कि आप जीत तो गए, अब यू हैव वन एंड यू हैव बिकम अ स्टार और यू हैव बिकम समथिंग एंड आपकी कंपनी चल गई है. इफ़ यू आर नॉट प्रिपेयर्ड, इफ़ योर प्लानिंग इज नॉट राइट, अगर ब्लूप्रिंट सही नहीं था पूरे समय क्रिएट करते, यू विल नॉट सस्टेन, राइट? सो व्हाट डू यू थिंक, व्हाट आर द कीज टू सस्टेन इन मार्केट?
सी, आई एम वेरी फर्मली बिलीविंग दैट यू हैव टू कंटिन्यू टू ग्रो. इफ़ यू कांट ग्रो, यू कांट stay, you can't sustain, you probably come out of it rather than let it die. Okay, so that's very important. In order to grow, what are the things that you have to keep in mind? What are the things that you should do? Is one is you got to have that hunger. You have to compare what others are doing, figure out their strategies, figure out their, what worked for them, what did not work for them. It may or may not apply exactly to you, but there is a lot to learn. And the learning will happen if you are curious. If you're curious enough. See the younger ones, very, very young kids, 3, 4, 5-year-old kids, who are just starting to talk, absorb languages. They have a lot of observations around them. They start to, ask questions which we never imagine. It isn't there in the plain sight, but we don't think of it. So as an entrepreneur, as a person who wants to constantly invest in growth or constantly work towards growing, you got to be very observant. You got to be very, very curious. Curious like a kid, is what I say. Figure out why is this happening? Why, let's say Apple. Why Apple is one of the best smartphone makers? What is it that they do? If you have opened an Apple product, right from the box till the product, just the package. We have not even seen the quality content. But the package quality itself tells you a different thing. Why it is happening, how it is happening, right? So if you give a very, you have to focus on the smaller aspects also. Finer aspects also, and you have to understand how you can improve in those areas. And ultimately it becomes a full package where the entire engine, the entire machinery is working towards achieving a better goal or a better benchmark from your own benchmark. So if I was here, how can I go there? So you invest in yourself in so many ways. You got to be thinking all the time. What are the new things that you can adopt? One more thing I keep telling is do new things and do difficult things. So I have a very very recent example. I think 2-3 days ago, I have a 10-year-old Honda City, and there was an oil leakage, a very tiny oil leakage. So I asked my office member, Kishore Bhai. Now, the story of Kishore Bhai is very interesting. He happened to be driving car for Siddharth. And Siddharth observed that he is a very honest person. So what we did was we moved him into a procurement department in the company. And he now is the one who is taking all the procurement decisions for the office facilities and everything. So he was upgraded, and only because of his honesty as a individual. So this guy, since he knows car, and that's what I asked him, maybe, you know, figure it out how to get it done. He went, took the car, got to the workshop, came back by the end of the day and told me that, you know, there's two possible solutions to it. One is going to take longer and is permanent. It will be like welding the oil tank. There is a rupture in the oil tank and there's a very tiny hole. The other option is just empty it and put an AM seal. It will be a couple of hours. So you tell me what you want to do. Second, there was a problem with the door, keyless remote. So I got it fixed. Third, there is also a wheel alignment issue that I sense. Probably there is a poor tire pressure, but once you get it refilled, see if there is a wheel alignment issue. So now look at this. I asked him to fix or get a solution to a small problem that I was seeing. But he came back with the entire suggestions. And there are two solutions on the problem that I asked for. He got one fixed without asking. And he said he noticed another problem and told me that this is what you would want to probably do. So this is what I say is honesty to your work. This is what I say is creating wow, going beyond the expectation. And this is also excellence. Right? So if you do that, there is no stopping. So whether it is your journey to the top, whether you stay on the top or whether there are some other competitors coming into your business, it doesn't really matter. You are going to grow. You are going to be one of the successful in the eyes of the world. You are going to be happy with what you're doing. And this person, the reason why I shared this example is this person is not trained. He's not educated. He has jumped from what he was. I mean, he could have been a driver all along. But his one characteristic got him to this position. And now he is obviously growing. He's maximizing on that. So it was the strength that got him to this role. So that's what I say. You focus on your strengths. And focus on the excellence part. How can you deliver more than what is asked for? So if you have to be observant. You have to be, figuring out what all I can add to this situation. And come out with solutions, not just the problem. He told me that this is a problem, but he could come out with solutions, that these are the possibilities. Let the decision maker decide. But you're still giving full options. And that is the smartness. That is how you will be successful in whatever you start with. If you can go beyond the call of duty, if you can go beyond the expectations, then there's no stopping you. Plus, think of it, the selfish interest. You will be happy too. You'll be joyful at the reaction that the other person is giving to you. This is the real feedback that you're going to get. The person will be happy. And for sure, I can guarantee that the receiver will actually recommend you to 10 other people. Just like in a movie business, whatever movie you like, you talk to your friends, proactively tell them kya ro dekh ke aana. That is the power of delivering good, creating wow, excellence. That is the power. And there is no worry whether you would be falling down from where you are or whether you would be able to reach the top. Just continue to do this. That's it. Everything else is for the world to decide.
Okay. So the last question before we move to the rapid fire sequence is, if you start all over again, what would you change?
Absolutely nothing.
Absolutely nothing.
I'm happy with whatever it is. And I'm really enjoying the entire journey.
Uh-huh.
I'm happy with it.
So let's move this rapid fire round. Let's move there. So I'm going to be asking you questions and you'll have to reply in an instant without thinking.
Okay.
Right. So tell me about your morning routine.
Okay. So morning, is, I'm a lazy person. Either if I'm on a fitness, I'll be on the track. If I'm not, I'll be mostly just relaxing, chilling. So morning is mostly me time. And evening is mostly family time. So, yeah.
One habit that changed your life completely and how?
I would say two, reading and running.
Okay.
And reading made me much better person than I am, much more understanding and much more probably sensitive to other people's needs and probably more knowledgeable. Running is a newfound passion. I find running as very meditative. I find running as beating myself time over again and again. And that makes me feel good.
Absolutely amazing. So one lesson that you can never forget and why?
One lesson that I can never forget is dishonesty is not worth it. Again, a very personal story. I was probably a fifth grader or so. Just like you know, any other kid, you try to be smart. And I was in a candy shop and tried to steal a couple of candies. It was a home shop and the lady was inside and then she heard some noise and she realized there is something wrong. She figured out that I was stealing. And then, I was caught. I was abused. And she started abusing my father as well. And I know I was wrong, so I couldn't defend it. I just walked out, tears in my eyes. I realized that dishonesty is not worth it.
Okay.
There's no point.
Okay.
Should not be doing it. I think that was one of the lessons that stays with me.
Okay. What's the biggest motivation of your life?
Happiness.
Happiness.
And peace of mind, so to speak. I would be choosing happiness over anything else.
So, the last question, which is the most important question. If you ever write your autobiography, what would you name it?
I don't know if I'm going to write. But if I were to, I think it will be... I take every day as an adventure. My wife tells me I'm driving my car as an adventure. So she hates it. But I think if I were to name it, I probably will name it as Little Adventures, My Little Adventures.
Amazing, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for coming here. And this is where we end this podcast. Thank you so much for being here, sir.
My pleasure. And I hope I could convert at least one of your audience to an entrepreneurship journey.
Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. This means a lot.